Hello everyone, my name is Oeun. I'm nice to see you again. And in today's video, I'm going to teach you another noun clause. But at this time, I'm teaching you special function of noun clauses. You know my previous video about three types of noun clauses: dead clauses, W.h-word clauses, and if operator clauses. But those noun clauses function as object only. You realize that noun have many functions. For example, noun can be subject, object, subject complement, appositive, direct object, indirect object, object of preposition, or something like that. Okay. So in today's video, you are going to learn the functions of noun clauses. Okay, let's get started. Noun clauses. Uses of noun clauses in sentences. Okay, we have example and function in sentence. In fact, you know already there are three types of noun clauses: that clause, W.h-word clause, and if operator clauses. Example number one: whoever works during the lunch break get to leave early. Yeah, which one is a noun clause in this sentence? Whoever is subordinated, then from whoever to break here is noun clause. Noun clause. After noun clause is verb. Get here is verb. So, what is the function of the noun clause? It is function a subject. So the first sentence is that noun clause function as a subject. Example number two: the dentist treated whichever patient arrived first. Which one is noun clause? So from whichever to the first is noun clause. How about the function? So before noun clause is a verb. So treat is transitive verb. That's why this noun clause function as a direct object. Direct object. Number three, the teacher gave whoever presented an oral report extra credit because gave from the word give. Give is the transitive verb. That's why it has two of object, one direct and the other is indirect of object. So from who to report is noun clause. But extra credit is direct object. So what is the function of the noun clause? It is indirect object. Okay. Number three, our problem is whether we should stay here or leave. If whether we should stay here or leave. So from whether to leave here is noun clause. So what is the function of the noun clause? When it come after verb to be like this, it function as predicate, nominative. Predicate. Nominative or predicate noun, or you can call predicate nominative, predicate noun, or subject complement. That's okay because it comes after verb to be. Example number four: use the money for whatever purpose you choose. So whatever purpose you choose is noun clause, but this noun clause come after preposition for. So what is the function of this noun clause? It is object of preposition. Object of preposition. Object of preposition. Okay. The last example: the governor's dilemma. How it would be possible to please both factions require hard thinking. So noun clause from how to fractions is a noun, noun clause. So what is the function of the noun clause? Dilemma and how it would be possible to plead both fractions. It is a positive. It is a positive. Again, noun has many functions. Noun can be subject, object, subject complement, direct object, indirect object, object of preposition, a positive, a predicate noun, a predicate nominative. Okay, so this example, the first one is that noun clause function as a subject. When we can say that it is the subject, make sure that it come before verb. And the second one is that it direct object, because treated is a transitive verb. Then transitive verb need object. That's why it is only one object like this. It is direct object. Number three, our problem is whether we should stay here or leave. So whether we should stay here come after verb to be. So to be is the linking verb. That's why this noun clause function as a predicate nominative or predicate noun, or you can call it subject complement. It okay. And use the money for whatever purpose you choose. The noun clause function as object or preposition, because it come after preposition for. And the last one is the governor dilemma, how it would be possible to plead both factions require hard thinking. So how it would be possible to plead both factions here is noun clause, but it function is a positive. It is placed next to dilemmas. Okay, does it make sense, everyone? After my explanation, please bear in mind that noun has many functions, not only subject or object, but it has more than that. In order to recognize noun as a subject or object, you have to take a look at verb and position of each noun. You can recognize it. If rename the noun next to it, it can be a positive or something like that. So please be careful with the function of noun clauses. If you have any question about noun clause, especially about uses of noun clauses in sentences here, please write your questions. I try my best to reply to all of your questions. Well, this comes to the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for watching my video, but don't forget to watch it every day. A new video comes up a day. When you miss one video, you find it difficult to understand a lot of grammatical items because everything is taught in order. So please spend around 7 to 15 minutes per day. You can understand a lot from my lessons. Okay, thank you very much. See you later. Bye-bye.